I'm Robin Bensley, and it is chow time. And today, I want to take you to a little fishing village on the Amalfi Coast in Italy. And the dish we're going to make today is called pasta shatera. That is shatera. Now, after wandering around this beautiful little village for the morning, we decided to have lunch there. And we went to a restaurant, and we had this pasta tuna dish. It was very simple, but it was so delicious, and that's why I wanted to bring it to you today. In fact, I also have a picture of the restaurant. The chef is walking through the restaurant with this fish, this big old fish that he caught, and, you know, my immediate urge was to yell out, "Is the seafood fresh here?" But that would have been really dorky, so I didn't say anything, but it was a wonderful restaurant, and so I bring you pasta shatera, straight from the Amalfi Coast, Italy. The first thing I've done is cooked a couple of tuna steaks in the oven. I just poached them in a little white wine, nothing more than a couple of tuna steaks in white wine, and about 20 minutes on, at 375. You can also, you don't even have to do this step at all. You can just use a nice albacore tuna right out of a can. Okay, we're going to need 3 large onions for this recipe. And I have seen onions cut 100 different ways by people. Let me show you how I like to do it. This is actually the Julia Child method. So I've cleaned up my onion a little bit. You cut it right down through the core like that. And then you turn the sides over. You've got a nice flat surface to work with. And see all those ridges? Well, those are like little guidelines for you. So you slice along the ridges, but not all the way through, because you don't want it to fall apart. All right, I've chopped 3 large onions, which will go into a little bit of olive oil and a couple of tablespoons of butter for flavor. We want to cook this, all this onion up. This is like one of the main ingredients of the dish. We want to cook all of this up until it's nice and tender, and it brings out the natural sugars of the onion. And, you know, there's nothing like onions and butter and olive oil. The onions have been cooking for about 10 minutes, and when they're starting to get caramelized and a little bit of color to them, and they're tender, oh, man. What is it about just a panful of onions that just smells like you're making the most wonderful thing ever? When it gets to this point, we're going to start pouring a whole bottle of white wine in here, but not all at once. So after I've poured a little bit of, about a cup's worth of white wine on here, we're going to let it cook off. We're going to make a reduction sauce with the white wine, which means no stirring. Don't touch it. Just let the wine cook off and reduce, and it'll be nothing more than flavor with those onions. So a little bit at a time, you use the entire bottle of white wine, about a cup at a time, and you just let it cook off. You add a little bit more, you let it cook off until you have just a wonderful, flavorful reduction sauce. See, it's nice and moist. And then I'm going to crumple the tuna fish right in there. This is mascarpone cheese, which you can find in any grocery store, and it's simply fancy Italian cream cheese. It's actually richer and denser than regular cream cheese, and this is going to make the whole dish come together. It's going to make it creamy and wonderful. My pasta water is boiling, so I'm going to add a nice handful of salt. You never put oil into pasta water. This is what Italians have told me, so I trust them. They put a lot of salt in there. And then I happen to have fresh pasta. If you can get fresh pasta, it makes all the difference in the world. And fresh pasta only takes about 2 minutes to cook. Drain the pasta. Do not rinse the pasta. We'll put the pasta right into the serving dish. Oh, man. Ooh, look at this. Okay, it is done. It just needs just a little embellishment. So I like to put some fresh cilantro on top. And if you like, a little bit of tomato for color. Mm. Oh, wait, I'm supposed to try the pasta shatera. I think it needs a little bit of pepper, but other than that, it's perfect. And right now, I'm on the Amalfi Coast in Italy. That's where I feel I am.